Return of the Jedi really sucks. And that's coming from me, a huge fucking Star Wars fan, okay? I love Star Wars books, games, movies, shows. It doesn't matter. I just like Star Wars a lot. You guys already probably know that because my last few videos and streams have just been Star Wars. So don't start cracking your knuckles and typing about how I'm not a real fan because I have problems with this movie. Now, I'm not the oldest person here on the internet who makes a living complaining about things on YouTube. So I wasn't alive when Jedi came out. Regardless, as a fan of media and pop culture, I like to watch older movies with the mindset of the time period that they came out in. I try not to compare them to newer or more modern films. I like to think that if I saw Return of the Jedi for the first time, back when it came out, without seeing any of the newer Star Wars movies, I'd probably still think it sucks. Because it does. For the most part.
From a certain point of view.
Now I'm gonna try not to talk about anything in the special edition release of the movie. That really wouldn't be very fair of me. Even though there's a lot of shit that I really want to complain about. I'm not talking about that! No! Now get it out of my face! Now let me real quick mention a few things that I actually like about this movie. At the end of the day, I can go back and watch just about any Star Wars movie. Though, for some, I'm only watching them to get a good hearty laugh. Or because I hate myself. You know, man, I just like Star Wars. So there's quite a few things that I really love in this movie. For instance, number one, Luke Skywalker. Luke has never been more of a bona fide badass in this movie. We can really see how Luke has evolved as a Jedi and as a character in general. Luke force chokes the Gamorrean guards as his first on-screen act. From his first few lines, you can see how much more wise and powerful he is. It's evident that a lot of time has passed between the last movie and now, just based on how he speaks and carries himself. I also love how fucking savage he is. He just wails on people. Luke, have mercy, please. Number two, the effects. The practical effects in this movie are insane. I've watched a lot of documentaries on this movie, and there are some things that I still cannot fathom. They actually made the entire Sarlacc pit. The whole thing. That shit is real. They made three different effects for the Rancor before they found one that they liked. This shit? This is a fucking painting. So is this. There's actually a lot of paintings, but it's still really cool. Number three, Palpatine. Palpatine is so fun. Now, the Plinkett reviews put this pretty well.
The man seems to find such joy in being pure evil. You gotta respect that. He's fucking evil and he loves it.
And you know what? That is absolutely true. Sometimes a hammy, unapologetically evil villain is what we want to see in our blockbusters. Plus, we need a character who is more evil than Darth Vader so that we can believe in Vader's eventual redemption. Now, there's other little smaller things I love, but none of this stuff is enough to save the whole movie. So let's go and move on to what you all came here for. The shit I don't like. First and foremost, the performances in this movie are kind of all over the place. They're either really good or super awkward.
That's one.
General, count me in. No. Luke, run away. Far away. If he can feel your presence, then leave this place.
The characters just don't feel like they did in the last two movies. This is acceptable in the case of Luke, but that's because he's changed a lot, and Mark Hamill is obviously doing a much better job than the other guys. Han and Leia act different for no real reason. Oh wait, no, I know the reason. It's because of the director. It's the same reason Oscar-nominated Felicity Jones is really boring as Jyn Erso. Gareth Edwards doesn't really like directing characters. He prefers to make really cool visuals. And that's fine. The guy who directed Jedi probably just let Hamill, Ford, and Fisher just take the reins on their performances. You know, guys, you know, you've been doing this for two movies already. Just do whatever you want. At least that's how it feels. I don't know. That's just a guess. It feels especially apparent in the case of Harrison Ford. What I'm trying to say is Han is really boring in this movie. He's boring as balls. Probably because at this point, Harrison Ford really wanted Han to be killed off, which would have been much more narratively moving. Han is the best part of the first two movies. He's cool, he's funny, he's sarcastic. Everybody loves Han Solo because of these first two movies. Here, he's just a bumbling, boring idiot. He feels like a character on Friends, not the gunslinging hero that we once knew him as.
All right.
Right.
He feels like a guy who doesn't want to do anything exciting. He begs Lando to fly the Falcon in the final battle. He hasn't been in the Falcon in a long ass time. Why wouldn't he want to do it himself? Also, why is he so chummy with Lando? Because the last time we saw him, Lando left him to fucking die. He betrayed him. Why is this plotline completely dropped? Luke, Chewie, and Leia learn to forgive Lando, but Han didn't get that chance. He's been in fucking cryostasis. His personality overall just feels softer and more subdued for some weird, unexplainable reason. He still has like one or two funny lines. No, he has like one.
I used to live here, you know.
You're gonna die here, you know. Convenient.
But most of the time, he's just along for the ride instead of actually calling the shots. I don't know. Maybe he's just like really tired. I kind of feel tired. Because this movie's so boring! This movie puts me to fucking sleep. It is so boring. The previous movies weren't big dumb action movies, but the pace was kept up with exciting and intense moments. The first movie starts with a chase scene. The princess gets caught by the bad guys. She sends messengers on an escape pod to meet with a young boy and a wizard. Then they have some close encounters before they hire some shady scoundrels to get them off the planet. And then it just gets more and more exciting from there. In Empire Strikes Back, you have the main hero being attacked by fucking Bigfoot in the snow, gets caught in a snowstorm, and then he gets rescued by his friend, but right afterwards, the bad guys attack their base with a full frontal assault that our heroes barely escape. The main character is sent to a mysterious world to learn ancient magic, and the other characters are on a cat and mouse chase through the galaxy for the rest of the movie. Nothing in Return of the Jedi really feels that urgent. Han doesn't need to be rescued right away. He can technically just hang out there for a little while. He's not going anywhere. The Empire isn't really making any big moves to snuff out the rebellion, even though in the last movie, they were. It's called The Empire Strikes Back. Why did they stop striking? Palpatine explicitly tells Vader not to attack the rebels in this film. I guess he'd rather host cocktail parties with these spooky friends of his.
I told you to remain on the command ship.
A small rebel force has penetrated the shield and landed on Endor.
Yes, I know.
What the fuck happened? Did everybody get bored? Did Palpatine just get bored of fighting this war? These clowns don't even seem to care anymore. Like, yeah, it's implied that Palpatine can predict whatever's going to happen, but then again, he seems to be bluffing for a lot of it, or just making really good educated guesses, based on obvious information. Plus, if he's so good at seeing the future, how come he didn't see this coming? Maybe he was just really tired that day. I'm tired too. I'm so sleepy. Now, my biggest issues that I have with this movie happen in the very first act. Han's rescue at Jabba's palace. Here's the problem I have with this whole opening arc. Other than it being really, really unexciting for some reason, Luke's plan is so convoluted and it relies on way too much stuff happening. His plan had absolutely no right actually working. Now, if you guys don't remember, here's exactly what happens. First, he sends R2-D2 and C-3PO to Jabba with a recording of him asking for an opportunity to bargain for Han's life. As an offer of goodwill, he apparently is giving R2-D2 and C-3PO to Jabba. Jabba decides, fuck that, and he keeps the droids anyway. Luke then sends Leia, disguised as a bounty hunter, to turn in Chewbacca as a bounty. Then she threatens him with this bomb so that he gives her more money for the bounty. Why? I don't know. I'll get to this later. Anyway, then she stays overnight so that she can thaw Han out of the carbonite, but then she gets captured herself. So now everyone in Luke's crew is captured. So Luke goes to the palace himself, steals a gun, and tries to shoot Jabba in the fucking face. Then he falls down a trapdoor, fights a meatball monster. I'm not even going to talk about this because the rancor fight is actually the only exciting thing that happens in the sequence, so we're just going to leave that alone. But now Luke is captured as well, so Jabba decides to kill them all by throwing them into the Sarlacc pit. Alright, so first of all, why did he give C-3PO to Jabba too? C-3PO doesn't even know the plan. Why wouldn't he at least tell him the plan if he's supposed to be a part of it? Wouldn't it risk your plan going horribly wrong by not telling one of your friends about it? I guess people would be upset if C-3PO wasn't there. Sure, whatever. It should also be noted that 3PO is fitted with the restraining bolt, which means that if Luke let him in on the plan and needed him to do something really important, he wouldn't have been able to. Restraining bolts make it so that droids can't disobey orders. Yeah, you can check the facts on Wikipedia, or you could just watch A New Hope, where they're used for the first time. Also, what if they put a bolt on R2? Then I guess he wouldn't have been able to give you your fucking lightsaber. Wait a minute. Why don't they put a bolt on R2? They explicitly don't do it, for no reason. Secondly, what was Leia's plan with the thermal detonator? Jabba isn't stupid. They say multiple times that he is a very cunning individual. Mind tricks don't even work on the guy. So what if he was like, okay, just use the fucking grenade, you idiot. You'll kill everybody, and then you're not gonna get paid, you fucking moron. It's not like the detonator is even used again in the movie. It's not like a Chekhov's gun or anything. It's just forgotten about, and the grenade's gone. Don't worry about it. Why does she even need more money from Jabba? This serves no purpose. I don't understand why this is here. Thirdly, does this whole plan hinge on the idea that these events will happen exactly in the sequence that they occur? Can Luke see the fucking future? The way that Luke is nodding at everybody in this scene, it makes me think that this is exactly what he wanted to happen. How the fuck could he have known that Jabba would capture them all, keep them alive, drive them out to the desert with all of his friends on the sand skiff, and feed them to a giant monster in the sand? Who the fuck can predict all of that? You must be really good at chess, Luke. Like, what if Jabba just killed them in a way that doesn't allow you to have an open brawl with everybody? What if he just tortured them? Or disintegrated them? Because we've seen that he's fully capable of doing both of those things. What's stopping him from killing everyone before Luke gets there? What if he decided not to bring R2 on the sand skiff? Then you don't get a lightsaber. What if somebody died? Also, was Luke's endgame just to start fighting everybody? He doesn't even go for Jabba himself. What if Leia was incapable of overpowering this hulking monster? You had a lot of faith in your unarmed, naked sister. Leia has proven before that, yeah, she's pretty badass. But what if her fight had been any more difficult? She kills him in a room full of his friends and colleagues, and no one tries to stop her. I mean, I guess she beats him anyway, so whatever. It doesn't matter, I guess. Here's the thing. If Luke was just planning on a full frontal assault, why not just whip out the fucking lightsaber right from the very beginning in the palace? Like, don't send anybody else in, just fight everybody on your own, because obviously you can handle them all. That was never really a concern of his. Now don't say, oh, well, Luke wouldn't do that because it's not the Jedi way. He's murdering these people! Now to top all this shit off, Boba Fett dies like a bitch. Yes, I said he dies, because as far as the new canon is concerned, he's dead as fuck. Not only does he get killed by Han on accident, he screams like a wuss and then gets eaten by a horrifying hentai monster that burps cartoonishly afterwards.
How embarrassing!
In the last movie, there's a really cool scene where Boba gets the jump on Luke. Luke is like sneaking around Cloud City when BAM! Boba Fett out of fucking nowhere. But it's not out of nowhere. In the previous shot, if you look in the background, you can see when Luke unholsters his blaster, Boba hears him and turns his head. He was ready for his ass. He is fully prepared. But none of that coolness is present in this movie. So that's the first third of the movie. And aside from some cool stuff, it pretty much sucked. So the second arc must be better, right? Yeah, no. It's not better. The entire middle portion of this movie is occupied by fucking Ewoks. This subplot is so unimaginably dull. The team spends an entire third of the movie hanging out at Build-A-Bear Workshop. If the Ewoks were used significantly less than they were, things really wouldn't be that bad. The encounter where the heroes get captured and almost eaten is actually kind of fun. But Jesus Christ, this is what we get for the rest of the fucking movie. Luke and the gang spend the night here, eat dinner, fuck around. I mean, weren't you guys sent there to do something important? Don't you all have a job to do? So Luke gets himself captured because even he's sick of the Ewoks. Now you'd expect Luke's reunion with Vader to be an epic affair, because last time they were near each other, they were trying to kill each other. Vader mutilated him. Things got kind of emotional. No! But this is how it happens in this movie.
This is a rebel that surrendered to us. Although he denies it, I believe there may be more of them.
It's so fucking dull! We get some interesting dialogue between Luke and Vader, but it's not really necessary for things to pan out in this way. This stuff could have happened in a much more climactic manner. This is how you run into an ex-girlfriend, not the evil cyborg space wizard that happens to be your dad. Now luckily, we're moving into the final act of the movie, and by this time you would think that things might get exciting. Right? Well...
Exciting is hardly the word I would choose.
This final battle is almost good. It takes a little while for Sheev to goad Luke into fighting, but as a viewer, you can see the battle getting worse and worse for the rebels, and Luke must feel pretty hopeless at this point. He probably thinks that fighting his way out of here is the only option he has left. Then there's this really good reveal about the Death Star actually fucking working. This is one of the only good dramatic reveals in the movie. You know what? No, it's the only one. But the problem with this climax is that there's just too much going on. And not a lot of it is that interesting. Ewoks are fighting stormtroopers, Han and the crew are trying to destroy the shield generator, Lando's leading the assault in space with Admiral Ackbar, and Luke is fighting Vader. Now, there are only one and a half of these plot lines that are actually interesting. Luke versus Vader, and the Death Star assault in space. The space battles look really visually impressive, and you feel the stress of the fleet as they get caught in two traps.
It's a trap!
Yeah, I know it is. I say one and a half because the focus should definitely be more on Luke than anything else. This is his movie. It's called Return of the Jedi. Whether that refers to Luke returning or Anakin returning to the light, the action should revolve around these two characters. In their last movie, their duel was actually pretty long. They went all over the fucking place. And here, it's much shorter because there's just so much other shit that's crammed into the climax. The fight is good, yeah. And the character stuff that we get for Luke is great. But then we have to look at more dumb shit in between all this. Oh, look, they throw rocks on their heads. They throw rocks and they have little sticks. This is really exciting. It's not exciting. I'm lying. It's not exciting. Now, I could keep going on and on. But look, the movie's fucking over. That was it. It was 2 hours and most of it was pretty fucking boring. And yeah, I say it over and over again, but that's the only thing wrong with this movie. It's boring. I could compile maybe a half hour of fun and interesting content from this movie, and some of that stuff would be among my favorite Star Wars moments. Like the last fight. The fight between Luke and Vader is actually really fucking interesting. But that's just not enough for me. So I can't help but imagine how the movie could have been made just a little differently to make it a lot more exciting. You know what would have been cool to see? If this movie was paced a little differently and featured different scenes, we could have gotten to see a really good grand scale adventure, chronicling how the Rebel Alliance brings the band back together and stops the Empire once and for all. Start the movie with Jabba's palace. Let us see him and get a sense of how shitty a person he is. Maybe show how Lando gets planted into the palace, have Luke show up, offer a peaceful negotiation, then just fucking let loose and fight everybody with Lando's help. They can fight Boba Fett and have Boba get a really good final fight that feels satisfying. Maybe the other characters actually do get captured in a previous unseen attempt to save Han. Maybe they already planted themselves like Lando did. This can be done so that we can see all the characters doing something cool in the first few scenes. Have a quick opening action scene to set the stage and get the group back together. Then have Luke go back to Dagobah, split up with the party so that he can talk to Yoda and Obi-Wan, since this is a plot point that's actually worth revisiting. Then cut between Leia and the other characters on a counteroffensive against the Empire. Have the Rebels, who have been relatively hidden since the last movie, leading full assaults against Empire bases. Our characters can be seen as war heroes, strategic masterminds. We can see their full evolution as heroes actively fighting and winning the war. We could see some kind of battle or skirmish where they come across information about the second Death Star. Then they regroup and plan the assault on the second Death Star. Keep the final battle separated into two halves. Han, Leia, and the others fighting the Empire's forces, either on the ground or in the air, doesn't really matter, while Luke fights Vader inside the Death Star. The Jedi doesn't even have to be the only thing returning. Basically, have the overall theme be the heroes returning to form. I feel like I'm giving suggestions for a movie that isn't even out yet, and the disappointing thing is that this movie already fucking happened, and I'm not the biggest fan of the final product. There's still a lot of effort being put forth, but overall it stands as the weakest movie in the trilogy, with help from some glaring issues that a lot of people ignore. Also, that stupid-ass song in the special editions. Yes, I'm going to talk about it. I can't hold it in any longer. The CGI is already dated. How does the CGI in the prequels look perfectly fine, but this looks like fucking garbage? Why did they refilm the whole sequence? They even got that same dancer girl. Good thing black don't crack because she looks exactly the same. But still, do you really need to redo the whole scene? That's just a waste of resources. This scene isn't even that important. It lasts like a minute. And the song you made is hilariously bad. I don't know what these things are. These things? Yeah, but they're not fucking brass instruments. So how are they making that noise? This motherfucker just has a harmonica. It's just a regular harmonica. Why is there a sexy Rodian woman with breasts? Where do these drums come from? They weren't even in there before. This isn't Star Wars. This isn't Star Wars.